Hi everyone. Have you ever tried to learn software engineering when you are starting your career and you are in a very beginning stage? When you search on internet, you found that there are various tutorials available for high level design or low level design or coding. For high level design, they will tell you how to build Uber. If you want to learn low level design, they will teach you how to crack the interview or how to learn all the 23 design patterns. If you try to learn coding, they teach you how to parse a linked list. But I found that there is nothing on internet which combines everything into one place. That is, how do you learn the basic things in one place so that at least you can get started? Of course, you do not need to learn all the design pattern in one go when you are starting. You just need to learn a little bit so that you can get started. This video is an announcement of a playlist which I have been creating since last 3 months, and it contains around 18 videos, and it contains the videos related to not just the front end or back end or anything else, but it contains a video related to software engineering. So if you follow this particular series of 18 videos, you will learn not just the coding, that is how to code a REST API in Java, but also you will learn various aspects of engineering. For example, why I am choosing Java as my language, and then why I am choosing a particular database, how to analyze the requirement, how to create a document for the requirement, and then, of course, deploying everything to Azure and maybe creating some tables and why a particular table is created. So there are a lot of things which you will learn, and at the end of the tutorial, what will happen is that you will have something like this, an e-commerce platform, which will have a login with Google button. You will be able to log in and see the various things available here. You can also go to the Swagger endpoint where you can find the Swagger URL, that what are the APIs which are exposed. So you see, we have a Swagger UI which will be loaded in a while. And here in the e-commerce platform, you can add things to cart, whatever you want to. So while doing this, many APIs are being called. These APIs are being set up here as a REST API. And then you can just place the order. So all those things like login with Google, building a very simple UI, all these things require a bit of engineering to learn. Your things will be deployed on Azure, and the database also will be deployed on Azure. So those things will be there. Apart from this, the code will be launched on Git. So you will learn how to set up Git repo on local, how to create a pull request. And then whenever you commit your change or push any change to Git, what will happen is that it will generate a CI/CD pipeline, and in turn, it will deploy things on Azure. So the moment you push any change here on Git, the things will be deployed on Azure automatically. So that is called as CI/CD, that is continuous integration and continuous delivery. So those things also you can configure. Just to give quick idea on the things which I have in this playlist is, of course, the first is why I'm choosing Java. That will be the first video. Then we'll set up Maven. Then we'll set up IntelliJ, which is an IDE. Most likely, if you are having a REST API, then most likely it will be a Spring Boot application. So we'll set up that. Then we'll set up Git on local. We'll of course set CI/CD on Azure and GitHub, so that whenever you commit your change, the change automatically gets deployed on Azure. Then we'll integrate login with Google. So we'll talk about how to set up login with Google in this particular video. Then we'll set up some of the configurations. For example, not everything can be put in code. Many things need to be put in the config. And based on the config, you can choose what code path to take. So we'll set up how to set up config in Spring Boot, and then how to set up in Azure as well. And then we'll talk about setting the logging. So whenever you log anything, that log should appear in console or wherever. After that, we'll set up the monitoring on Azure. So what will happen is that if something goes down or some API latency increases, you should be able to see those things in the dashboard. So we'll set up that. Then we'll set up the logging on Azure. So for example, if you log anything on your service, and if the customer approaches you and says that this thing is not working, so those things also you can check with the help of logging. So we'll set up logging on Azure, because logging on local is fine when you are developing and coding, but the logging on Azure is also important. There are popular tools to do that. For example, there is a logging solution by Azure itself. The other is Splunk, but I'm using Azure here. Likewise, you can use anything else. And here, many interesting concepts are also being talked about logging. Now, it's not just the text-based logging. It is much more than that. So we'll talk about that. And then we'll just move to the requirement analysis, that what kind of requirement the team has given to us. We'll analyze that, and based on the requirement analysis, we'll choose the database, what database to have. In our case, we are choosing Azure SQL database because it suits our use case. It is important to know that why are we choosing a particular database. No database is bad, but whenever you make a choice, it should be an informed choice. So that's what we'll do here. Then we'll set up Azure SQL database on Azure. Then we'll create some tables on the Azure SQL database. Here also we'll give some thought that why a given table looks the way it looks. And while doing so, we'll set up multiple things on tables. For example, primary key. Then we'll set up unique key constraint. And then we'll set up foreign key. I know for database itself, it's an ocean in itself, right? But we'll just talk about the basic concepts and the basic queries. Then what we'll do is that we have a Java application running, right? We'll connect the Java application to the SQL, Azure SQL database. So how to set up those things I have talked about in this particular video. And not just talked about, I have set up the code repo as well. Then we'll do the Spring Boot MVC, that how to have a REST API, how to have a service and database and all those things. And eventually a small UI, the small UI which we see here. It's a very simple UI. So how to set up a UI in a Spring Boot application, that is also talked about using Thymeleaf. So there are many ways to set up the UI. So in this way, what will happen is that you'll end up with a website which you can share with your friends and they can do a bunch of operation. And whenever they do a bunch of operations, bunch of APIs will be called. And then based on that, you can take action. And not just that, whenever you build an app's website, you need to have some kind of authentication. So the authentication, that is login with Google, is also configured. Of 18 videos will help you, and it will contain various topics. If you are starting this playlist, put some time to understand the topics and then try to clone the repo. First, you clone the repo, run the code, and then see how things work. Particular series will not be a tutorial kind of series where what will happen is that I'll not say that type class Anubhav, then you will type class Anubhav. It will be mostly in the direction where you will observe the changes, clone the repo, and then learn the things. So that's the idea here in this particular series. I hope that this will help you to understand various things and link everything together. Link the high level design, link the low level design, link the system design and everything, whatever you learn in the software engineering, into one place. It's not going to be a separate thing for everything. So even then, when I started this series, I thought I can complete everything in 10 videos, but it looks like the software engineering is quite wide. So still I could compress everything into 18 videos, 18 or 19 videos. So do check out this series and do let me know. So what I'll do is that I'll post one video every week so that it's not overwhelming for everyone. And if any questions come, then I can answer those questions. Till the next time. Bye.